Hey there, Tamir from FibonacciTraders.com here with another weekly market recap video. Another sunny day here in Copangan, so if you're around, let me know, let's meet, let's prepare together for the rest of 2023, let's talk stocks. So, without further ado, please hit the like and subscribe and stay for the rest of the video. We will go over the weekly charts. We will start with the SPY, and as we can see, fifth time SPY touching and closing the week just on this major trend line. This trend line goes all the way from December 2021 and it's holding as a very tough resistance for all the lower highs. So now, once again, closing on this trend line, let's see if we can get finally a break up and above this trend line going towards the 410 and then the 428 area, and then we shall see. QQQ also trying to retest this trend line, this white trend line that started over January of 2022 and helps us identify the lower highs since, and every time, as we can see, price action touched this trend line, it got rejected. So stay tuned. We are going for a very interesting first quarter of 2023, because if the Qs will break up and above this white trend line and above the 290 area, we can see a double bottom scenario going all the way to 337 and maybe even 374. But for now, we trade the candles, we follow price and use trend lines and Fibonacci levels to manage the risk, because in the end of the day, in the end of the week, no one knows what will happen next. IWM breaking up and above this blue trend line that started over November 2021. And now, finally, after three consecutive dojis of this yellow trend line, we are getting a break up and above, and maybe the IWM, the Russell 2000, and maybe the Russell 3000, we also need to check it. I will check it and post it on Twitter, so make sure you follow me there also. Let's see a break up and above this 190 area towards above the 202. And once it will continue to the upside, I will update the levels to watch. Dow Jones back to the 345 area. And if we look left, we can see that the 345 area, 350 area is a very interesting area of support and resistance. Since May of 2021, we can see hovering up and below this area here, broke below, touched, rejected, and now going for, once again, retesting this area, breaking up and above, and 366, all-time high on the Dow Jones, is in the cards. Jets. As we are following this ETF since few weeks ago, we said once price will manage to break up and above, we will get a small rally on this ETF, and here we are. Almost 10% on the weekly to the upside, breaking above this trend line. Let's see continuation. We take Fibonacci swing low, swing high. Next resistance will be the 2050 and above it, 2242. This is all we need to do. Follow price and use levels and trend lines to manage the risk. Next on the list, we have TAN Solar ETF. And as we can see, it's all about understanding the relationship between price action, aka candlestick analysis, and trend lines. Nothing more, nothing less. no other indicators or oscillators we really need on the chart. We see clearly that this trend line is holding as a very major resistance for price action, because every time price reached this trend line, it got rejected to the downside. And now, past week, price closed just on this trend line. Let's see if once and for all we can break up and above this trend line, and then we take Fibonacci swing low, swing high, and it doesn't matter where you put it, it will give you levels to manage risk to the upside or to the downside. If you want to be a Fibonacci master, become your own indicator, stop following others, and to be able to become a consistent trader for the long run, check out the links in the description below. Join Fibonacci Traders Discord and check the mentorship one-on-one live program that we have. XLB, another ETF on my watch list, because if we take Fibonacci, we can clearly see that the 85 area, 84.50, is a very interesting level of support and resistance since May of 2021. Now, price going to retest it again as resistance, and once it will break up and above, it will go and retest the 90 and maybe even 97. Fibonacci gives us levels of resistance and future support. Bitcoin on the weekly, very strong week so far. And as we can see, price is very similar to the price action we had few weeks ago during November to the downside. Now we have the same candle to the upside, to the 21,500 area. We can see this area is a very strong resistance. If it will break above this trend line, look left where this trend line started, November 21. Every time price reached this area, it got rejected. And now, once again, price touched this area and got slightly rejected. Let's see where it will take us. Can we break to the upside towards the 25 and maybe even the 27,800. Apple is next. After two consecutive doji's on the weekly of the 127, we got a bull reversal candle to the upside. Now, bulls of Apple needs to break up above and close above the 135, because just by looking left, 135, very strong support. Now, it will be a very tough resistance, so pay attention for the 135 on Apple. Tesla is next. 3 weeks, three consecutive dojis, indecision, almost 3 weeks and more of indecision on Tesla. So patience on Tesla. Let's see where price will take us, to the upside, 150, to the downside, 81. These are the two major support and resistance levels that I'm looking for the near future. Nvidia trying to go back to retest this trend line. This trend line goes over from November 2021. And as we can see, once again, every time price touched this trend line, got rejected. Now let's see if Nvidia bulls have enough power in their hands to break up and above, and then we have all these levels for future resistance for price action. If once again this trend line will reject price to the downside, we have these levels to the downside for future support. Netflix, 337, as expected, as we talked about this level in the past several videos, and on our Discord. We said that once price will close the gap, it will reach the 337 and it will be a tough level as resistance, because just by looking left, all we need to do is look left. This is why I say it over and over on my videos. Always look left. This is the only way to identify support and resistance for price action. 337 support. Now, as we can see during December, it was resistance, and now once again resistance. Let's see if we can keep this uptrend channel intact. Above 337, this trend line and the 400 will be the next resistance on the weekly. Amazon, very strong week, 14% to the upside. Four consecutive dojis, 86, 85 area, managed to hold the support. Now, to the upside, let's see continuation towards the 105 and above it, 120. Meta, if we look back, Meta since October lows until Friday's close, 54% to the upside on Meta. But don't get FOMO, because if you look left, Meta came down from 387 towards the 88 and now giving back some, but to the upside it has a lot more to give. Next level of major resistance will be the 155. Once again, thank you very much for watching. Please hit the like, subscribe, share with your friends, and most importantly, hit the notification bell, because at least two more videos coming up this long weekend. One of them, my top stocks to watch for next week. Till the next video, enjoy the rest of your weekend.